I'm going to share my most useful hacks for tinting frosting for tricky colours like black, red, and navy. Black frosting is the most common struggle, so let's start with that. There are two secret ingredients here, chocolate chips and cocoa powder. Put the chocolate chips in the microwave for 30 seconds at 70% power so they don't overheat and seize, and then stir the chocolate until it's smooth, with no lumps. Leave it to cool to room temperature. Meanwhile, add hot water to the cocoa powder a little bit at a time until it makes a thin paste with no lumps. I use about 2 tablespoons of cocoa powder and 1 tablespoon of water for every cup of buttercream. When the chocolate and cocoa mixture are at room temperature, add them to your frosting. I like to do this before adding the milk or cream in my 4-minute buttercream recipe, so that the buttercream is much stiffer than it would normally be, because the liquid cocoa powder and melted chocolate will thin out the buttercream a lot, making it silky smooth and easy to spread or pipe. If you've already added milk or cream, then the chocolate and cocoa powder might make the buttercream too runny. Now add black food colouring, and I definitely recommend gel colours over liquid colours, because they're much more concentrated. I buy little bottles of coloured gels, but for black I use bigger bottles, since you need so much more gel. You'll need a generous squirt of gel, but not nearly as much as you'd need if you were using liquid colours. Stir it in, and you're aiming for a colour that's darker than grey, but not yet a true jet black. Cover the bowl with plastic wrap and leave it for an hour for the colour to develop and darken, and ta-da! A true black buttercream frosting. These first 2 hacks will work for any dark colour of buttercream, like navy blue. Start by adding chocolate to your frosting, ideally melted chocolate and cocoa powder, but you can use one or the other if you don't have both. The darker the brown you start with, the less colour you'll need to add later. Adding just blue to brown will make a fairly dark blue, but to make navy, add some black as well. Go back and forth between blue and black, adding a bit at a time until the colour is almost as dark as you want it to be. Cover the bowl with plastic wrap, leave it for an hour, and voila! A beautiful deep navy buttercream. If you're struggling to achieve the colour shown on a bottle of gel, it's probably because you're not using enough gel. Gels are concentrated, but you do need to use a generous amount for really bright and bold colours. Covering the bowl and letting the frosting rest gives any gel colour a chance to develop. Look at the difference just 1 hour makes for this orange buttercream. Red frosting can be really tricky, but just like with any other colour, use a good amount of red gel, and then you can make the red frosting brighter by covering the bowl to let it rest for an hour. Another hack that works really well with red buttercream is to heat it. Scoop up no more than a third of the buttercream and microwave it for just 10 seconds. It will melt and get much darker. Add the melted buttercream to the rest of the red buttercream and mix it together, and it will look lumpy at first, but leave it to come to room temperature or speed up the process by putting it in the freezer for 5 minutes to make a beautiful deep red frosting that's silky smooth. A common question is how to avoid the bitter taste caused by using lots of gel. As well as limiting the amount of gel you use by using these methods, another hack is to add more flavour to coloured frosting. Add a bit of clear vanilla or almond extract, or even other flavours like lemon or mint, depending on the flavour of your cake, of course. The flavour will disguise any taste of the gel in the buttercream. All I taste in this bright red cake is the almond-flavoured red frosting, and my deliciously moist perfect chocolate cake and yummy Oreo filling. I hope this tutorial has been useful. I share everything I know about buttercream in my online mastercourse, The Basics of Buttercream, where you'll learn how to make buttercream, troubleshoot any issues like graininess, air bubbles, yellow buttercream, and also how to check and adjust the consistency for piping and frosting, how to frost a cake with super smooth frosting and sharp edges, how to store buttercream, and how to use it for lots of stunning, unique cake decorating techniques. To take the mastercourse on my cake school, click the link up here in the top of the screen or go to britishgirlbakes.com. Thank you for watching.